Good morning, everyone. This is Tube 87, and to those of you who keep the Sabbath, happy Sabbath. Now, today I'm going to do a quick lesson the football player Tim Tebow. First of all, self-professed Christian or believer, as I like to say, in professional sports is nothing new. In today's society, it's being made a big deal about because there's such a separation that when someone professes to loving the Heavenly Father, it's a really big issue that's blown out of proportion nowadays. You have to remember, before Tim Tebow, there was Reggie White, who died in 2004. He was a Christian and believer of the Heavenly Father. Everything he did conveyed that, the way he spoke and the things he did on and off the football field. There was not such a big deal made about that then. In fact, he was praised and reverenced because he stood on that foundation of belief. But nowadays, it's getting to a point where it's a taboo thing to do. If you do, you're someone worthy of being singled out. And this is where society and the world is going. We're embracing things like homosexuality and sodomy and bestiality and anything else, more so than we are embracing people that stand on a spiritual foundation anymore. So it's flipping. Now, with that being said, the fact that Tim Tebow plays football has nothing to do with heaven or the Heavenly Father itself. We are to do things to edify one another, glorify the Heavenly Father, and we are to do things that are good for us. When we're out here on a football field running around beating ourselves up, tearing limbs up, muscles, boxing rings, getting our faces kicked in, MMA and all these things, there is nothing that glorifies the Heavenly Father in that. It's not edifying to others, and it's definitely not good for us. This is something we choose to do as people, as man. We choose these things. Now, the fact that he's a believer and loves the Heavenly Father, that's worthy of reverence in itself. The fact that he chooses to stand on that foundation and pray in the middle of a football field, so to speak, or speak highly of the Father in his post-game interviews, all these things are good. These things are edifying to others, and they do praise the Heavenly Father. They're glorifying to him. And it is definitely good for any and all of us, because we need people to stand on the spiritual foundation and reverence the Father so that we may bring others to him. This is what his will is, that we do these types of things. So, with that being said, there was this recent survey that said 43% of whoever was polled believed that God is helping Tim Tebow win football games. Really? Like I said, the Father cares nothing about football. He cares about us winning souls. He cares about our character. These are the things that he's concerned about. He's concerned about us all being saved. Now, it's up to us how we go about this, but these are the things that heaven and its hosts are concerned about. Heaven and its hosts are not concerned about football games, how many dollar bills you have, how many diamonds you have, how big your house is. Now, it's not to be twisted with the fact that there are plenty who are blessed with wealth, but with wealth comes great responsibility. So those who are blessed with wealth, there's a responsibility attached to that. Not all people do what they're supposed to with wealth. So there are a lot of gives and takes in this, and a lot of things to be understood. But the Father does not care about us playing football, because we're destroying the temples that he has lent us. Turn with me to Romans 14:19. Now, Romans 14:19 reads, "Let us therefore follow after the things which make for peace, and things wherewith one may edify another. We are to edify one another. Now, to edify means to instruct or improve, especially in moral and religious knowledge. This is what we're supposed to be doing with one another, uplifting one another in that type of knowledge. 1 Corinthians 10:23 tells us that all things edify not. Look, some things we do, some things are available to us, but all these things aren't good for us. So we have to be careful what we choose to do. And in 1 Thessalonians 5:11, we're told to edify one another. That's part of what we're supposed to be doing. Edification. Edification. That is very important. That's one of the things we need to be doing. Now, we're also to glorify. We're to glorify His name and His will, the things that the Father wants us to do. Now, Matthew 5:16 tells us, it says to let your light shine before men and glorify your Father which is in heaven. So we're supposed to do these things. Now, Tim Tebow, he does this. He glorifies the Father. He lets his light about the Father shine in front of other men. That's edifying to others. So he's doing some of these things. Football is just a platform that he happens to be using. Now, if the Father has another mission for him that's to his will, he may play football for 1 year, 2 years, or 15 years, 16 years, like Reggie White did, and then come away from that and find his true calling. But believe me, professional football is not the calling that the Heavenly Father has for him, but it may be a path that he takes to get there. So don't get these things all confused and think that just because he's playing football and he loves the Heavenly Father that the Father is helping him win football games. No, he would prefer that he didn't even play football. He would prefer that he just started out following his will and doing his word. But we choose to do what we want to do. That's self. Self is always choosing, and then we try to get the Father glory or blame accordingly. No, we choose this. Now, also, there are things that have to be good for us. Football is not good for us. Why? Because we're out there beating up these temples that the Father has loaned to us. It's no different than someone in a boxing ring, an MMA ring, whatever, especially sports. We're out there abusing these bodies, even working extraneously hard in a regular everyday job is not what the Father will have us do. Yes, we're supposed to work hard and this and the other, but we're not to abuse these bodies. Now, turn with me to 1 Corinthians 3:16-17, and let's see what it says about these temples that the Father has loaned to us. 16, it reads, it says, "Know ye that ye are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you." 17, "If any man defile or destroy the temple of God, him shall God destroy, for the temple of God is holy, which temple are ye?" So, if we're out there beating up these bodies, drugs, sports, whatever the case may be, if we're causing damage to these temples that are an extension of Him, we're causing damage to Him. We're going to be held accountable for that. Now, the price of destroying these bodies usually leads to an early death. Reggie White died in 2004. He was 43 years old. He was a football player. He loved the Father. He stood on that platform. After he retired, he found more truth when he got away from football. But who knows, because of the abuse of over 15, 16 years of playing professional football that he put on that body, it may have contributed to his early demise. But if we're fortunate and if we're blessed enough, we will get an opportunity to come away from these things which aren't good for us and do something that is good for us and that's glorifying to the Father and that's edifying to others. Now, just like most of us, at some point, Tim Tebow may have a revelation, whenever that may be, and come away from the things that aren't glorifying to the Father and come entirely away from that and go the way the Father will have us go. And that's what we're all given, an opportunity at some point, some sooner than others. Reggie White, when he retired after 15, 16 years of professional football, he came to some realizations or a revelation of sort. He realized that the church was steeped in tradition, and he wanted to come away from that. He stopped going to church. He gave up traditions like Christmas. Now, the fact that he came away from the church is nothing new. People do it every day. People get tired of not finding what they want to find there. They're not getting what they feel they need from the church, so they come away from it. Now, Revelations 18:4 tells us, it says, come out of her, my people. Come away from these things that man is teaching us. We need to come away from Babylon, the confusion. If that means coming out of the church building itself, then we need to come away from that. We need to study the Word and find out what the Word is telling us. A lot of people aren't finding it in churches. A lot of people aren't finding it in the things that they're doing in their lives. People come away from things every day, searching and searching and searching for the truth. And if you search hard enough, long enough, and diligently enough, the Holy Spirit will bring it to you. But anyway, no is the answer to the question. The Heavenly Father is not helping Tim Tebow win football games nor anyone else. That's man chosen, but our love for him is something always worthy of respecting when someone will stand up and profess that. It's not something to be mocked. We are to take that and let that edify ourselves and others, and we're to do the same. So, with that being said, keep in mind that the Heavenly Father does not call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 287. I'm out.